bring memories of past glories. It'll bring... It'll bring memories of past glories. It'll bring new heights of belief and ambition. It'll bring the boldest hopes and the bravest dreams. It'll bring everyone to their feet. It'll bring a roar into every voice. It'll bring this great game into a nation's heart. It'll bring the world to us and us to the world. Women's Rugby World Cup, Ireland, August 2017. Bring it.
History. There's the first try. Scarlett is going to go all the way.
It's okay. I'm good. Let's have a total celebration, get a glass out. And we can do this until we pass out.
It's a brilliant try for the Irish.
Yeah. We won't come down until we hit the ground.
Yeah, pass out. Yeah, I'm in charge now. I'm a star and I put my cars down. I live a very, very, very wild lifestyle. Heidi and Audrina, eat your heart out.
It'll bring memories of past glories. It'll bring new heights of belief and ambition. It'll bring the boldest hopes and the bravest. It'll bring everyone to their feet. It'll bring a roar into every voice. It'll bring this great game into a nation's heart. It'll bring the world to us and us to the world. Women's Rugby World Cup, Ireland, August 2017.
Good afternoon. You're very welcome to the Belfield Bowl for this first ever November series for the Irish women's team. Ireland take on reigning world champions today, and as you join us, Rochelle Clark, who is breaking the English caps record, overtaking Justin Leonard, is leading the English team onto the pitch. I'm Adrian O'Farrell. I'm joined by Fiona Coughlin, former Irish captain, general legend of Irish women's rugby, and the person who made it fashionable to be beating the All Blacks.
Yeah, that's a huge moment there for Rochelle Clark leading the team out with 115 caps. You know, she's equaling Donna Kennedy's record at the moment, and no doubt there's more rugby left in her, so she'll no doubt go on to be the most capped women's rugby player ever.
So it's a very stern challenge facing the Irish team today. This pits the number 5 ranked team in the world, Ireland, against the number 3 ranked team in the world, but with the reigning world champions, and in many people's eyes still the team to beat in world rugby.
Definitely, and they welcomed him back some of their sevens players to the squad. You know, they'll bring a wealth of experience to the squad. And you look at the caps across the both teams, England are definitely the more experienced teams. And we have a number of girls getting their first cap today, with Nicole Fowley at 13, and then a couple to come off the bench as well.
So as the teams break up after the anthems and the crowd find their voice, Fiona, this is a seriously challenging November series for the Irish team. They're playing the number 1, 2 and 3 teams in the world here.
Yeah, challenging but hugely exciting to have this amount of rugby in November, which we've never had before, is brilliant.
So that was a minute's silence in memory of Anthony Foley, and poignant moment, particularly with Rosie being such a prominent feature of the Irish women's rugby scene and frequent commentator alongside us.
Yeah, I think it's a mark of respect for the Foleys as a family and what they've done for women, or for Irish rugby, both women's and men's rugby. And it was for Colin Dynand as well, who came on as sponsorship through Aon with the Irish team, and a huge supporter of the women's team.
So just to pick up again, next week Ireland have Canada and the following week New Zealand. And with 9 months to go to the Rugby World Cup, it's great preparation for that, particularly given that the Rugby World Cup is going to be played in Belfield. But is there a danger it's too challenging and may not be great for confidence if the results don't go their way?
No, I don't think so. I think they'll get a lot from these games regardless of what way the results go. You know, you're blooding more new players, you're getting depth in your squad, and you want to be playing against the best teams in the world to see where you're at 9 months out and see what you have to do. You know, it's hugely exciting to have this amount of rugby in November for Ireland, but for other teams as well. You have the likes of Spain and Scotland battling it out for that last European spot in the World Cup. You have Fiji, Japan and Hong Kong battling it out for the Oceania and Asia spot. So you have teams at every level playing across the board. It's brilliant.
Mm-hmm. So Nora Stapleton just about to drop off. England have the great benefit of having played just during the week against France, match that they won 10-5.
Yeah, they were a bit ring rusty in that game. It wasn't the greatest game ever, but I'm sure they'll be looking to fix a few things from that game.
So it's solid defence from Ireland there. Mary Louise Riley prominent in that. England though, go again, just one out. Their issue during the week, I believe, against France was a general lack of creativity. They scored two pushover tries off line-out mauls. Is that an issue for them ongoing?
No, I don't think so. I think it's bedding players back into their systems. You know, there's girls coming back from sevens. They need time to gel. You know, it was very ring rusty from both teams, the French team as well, and a lot of errors, knock-ons and things that you wouldn't expect. A bit of a wet night, but I would expect more from both teams.
So first touch there for Mairead Coyne. The links with Alison Miller. Ireland's first chance to get their hands on the ball. Bit of obstruction there, I think, by right wing Kay Wilson on Narissa Muldoon, but the referee let it go. Good space here for Ireland if they can get it wide. Sanupu to Coyne. Oh, it's Nicole Fowley actually getting her first touch in international rugby there. So Paul Fitzpatrick just pops a nice little ball on there to, was Lindsay Pete, was it? No, Ailish Egan. Muldoon again. She's taken out of that. It looked like as she was fetching the ball, would have should be a penalty in my book. Fitzpatrick again. Getting some good yardage. Muldoon, Lindsay Pete now. Oh, but that's knocked on in the tackle. Chance for England to counter, but it's kicked deep by Mason. And Alison Miller is in a race here. Wins the race, but doesn't quite manage to get the ball. So England have regained that. But that's very well done. Mairead Coyne. Muldoon to Naz Riley. Stapleton Ireland looking to go wide early here. Nupu again. Well taken by Burford and her centre partner. That's a penalty to Ireland for not releasing. It was a high tackle, actually, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was good sustained pressure through Ireland before the knock on. They were hitting it up through the middle, getting quick rucks. They were looking for the plus ones, popping it onto the support runner. Unfortunate then to lose it with a knock on in the middle of the park, and England clearing with a good kick and chase.
So Norris Stapleton finds touch just inside the English half.
It's a huge day for Paula Fitz as well, you know, captaining her country. Paula really came to the fore in the World Cup and has, you know, has been ever present since. And you know, she's one of the hardest working players on that Irish team, and I'm no doubt the girls will follow her today.
So Ireland walking slowly into that line-out. Expected maybe to be Maz Riley. Indeed it is. Good ball. Nearly intercept, but taken in by Ciara Griffin. That's good yardage, good momentum, quick ball. Stapleton again goes wide. And that's Mairead Coyme again making good yardage in traffic there. Stapleton. Paul Fitzpatrick again. Again, Ireland have good numbers out here. Claire Molloy. Not held. Oh, apparently she was.
Tough call, but that's a really good adventure from Ireland. They're looking to go wide, come back strong through the middle. The player's looking to move the ball, which is really, really encouraging.
He's got to find touch down the line. Just on the halfway line.
Yeah, Emily's probably one of the least experienced players on that English squad, but I think it was Danielle Waterman actually who kicked it, was it? But Emily Scott's huge potential coming up through the ranks. You know, Katie McLean's there on the bench, but I'd say Emily's learned a lot from Katie over the years and is looking to bring her own kind of game to the fore today.
So Vicky Fleetwood to throw. Good movement by England there. It's gone to the front. Oh, and that is great pressure from Marissa Muldoon there. So England recycle. Look to go wide. Again, good pressure. Irish defence up well. It's a big hit over there. Again, the Irish look well up for this. Getting off the line well, making some big hits. It looks like being held up, looking for the choke tackle. Indeed, Amy Pratt, to the great joy of the crowd. First real roar of the day as Ireland hold that up to force the turnover.
Really good intent from the Irish team, getting off the line really quickly. Nicole Fowley went in with a big hit. Lindsay Peat and a few of the other forwards in there holding England up. First scrum of the game now, be interesting.
Yeah, big smile on Lindsay Peat's face there. She came away from that.
Yeah, this is Lindsay's first start, so she's out to make that jersey hers.
She's extraordinary. I didn't realise she's won a GAA All-Ireland medal with Dublin and is also co-captain of the Irish senior women's basketball team.
She's
extraordinary.
A phenomenal athlete, a huge amount of experience at high-level teams, and she's bringing it here to the Irish team as well. You know, she's new enough to rugby, so she still has a lot to learn, which is promising as well.
First one being reset. There's a hugely experienced front row up against them in Rochelle Clark, obviously, and Vicky Fleetwood and Laura Keats, also very established at 52 and 53 caps each. That's solid though by Ireland. Muldoon comes across. Again, Ireland look to go wide. Fowley, not quite held by Murray Coyne. Stapleton not quite able to pick it up. It goes into touch for an English throw-in. There do appear to be gaps there wide, though.
The space is out here wide. England are defending quite narrow. I don't know if they expected Ireland to move the ball out wide so quickly, but straight off first phase, they're looking to hit these wider channels, you know, and then it's just hands that let them down on that attempt. But in the scrum, it was good, solid scrum, but it would be better if we kind of get it up on the right a little bit to just create more space for our 10 and our backs out here.
So Latoya Mason to feed. And solid Irish scrum. Sarah Hunter takes that away. She's a very powerful runner.
Yeah, Sarah's up for World Player of the Year tonight at the World Rugby Awards. She's had a brilliant season and she's captain. She took over the captaincy from Katie McLean and she's done a sterling job in a tough 2 years for England.
And that's a good break, nearly out the back pass, but it got knocked on there. But powerful running again there from Marley. Actually, it was Marley Parker, yes, that took that in. There's a late change in the English team today in the back row when Izzy Noel-Smith came in to replace Alex Matthews, who had been very impressive recently.
Yeah, Alex, huge potential as well. She's only in her early 20s, but on the other night against France, and again in the summer series, she was coming back from injury, and she's a big ball carrier, really elusive player as well, and really exciting prospect.
So Nora Staples able to find touch of that penalty just inside the English 10-metre, and first chance maybe to establish some real field position here from this.
Yeah, most of the game's been played around the halfway line with no team really getting much traction.
So Cliona Maloney finds Mary Louise Riley. That's neatly worked. Claire Malloy into the midfield. Stapleton finds Fowley. It's a solid tackle there by English number 12, Rachel Burford. It's a penalty though for Ireland. And that's a mark taker, but it's going to come back for the penalty to Ireland. Not rolling away after the tackle.
Again, Ireland using Maz Riley to good effect in the line-out. You know, I would have thought England would have tried to mark her out of the game, which is tough because she is 6 foot odd, but you know, they're leaving her free to move where she wants.
So now a real chance to establish the first meaningful field position of the day. Tram Tierney would be happy enough with the start that Ireland have made, though, Fiona.
Yeah, definitely. They've started with such intent, both in attack and defence. And
oh, it hasn't made touch, unfortunately. Let's pop back inside, and Danielle Waterman decides to run back out. Claire Malloy, Lindsay Pico after. It's good work by Claire Malloy there. So Scott over the head of Alison Miller, and Nora Stapleton is all the way back. Or it's not Miller, it's actually Murray Coyne back there with her. So Muldoon organising her troops. Paul Fitzpatrick, the first runner of choice today. That's Olaf Fitzsimons taking this one on. Claire Malloy, such a dynamic player, isn't she?
She's fantastic. I think she's one of the best sevens in the world. And, you know, she always out to prove a point, but particularly so against England today with six of her teammates on the English club teammates on the English team.
You know, Stapleton nearly getting Murray Coyne through a gap there, but taken down. And again, Ireland patiently.
It's good width from Ireland.
Yeah. Sending an oopo now. Inviting the inside ball from Nicole Fowley, but takes the tackle. Again, very good retention and possession. Lindsay Peat. It's an injury here to Ireland. I think it's sending an oopo down there. Slow possession this time. And Nora Stapleton has to go in. Sending an oopo is back on her feet. I'm glad to relate. Again, well done. Saved again. Ooh, that was nearly an intercept, but Cleveland Malloy, but Murray Coyne is away. But penalty against Ireland, this occasion for not releasing after the tackle.
Yeah, Murray Coyne's shown up well in attack. She plays a lot of her club rugby and interprovincial rugby at full back. So last year she was on the wing for Ireland, probably a little bit out of her comfort zone, but she's really shown up well in attack here for Ireland.
Yeah, it should be pointed out Ireland are missing two of their leading lights and Niamh Briggs at full back and Sophie Spence in the second row, so two very influential players for Ireland.
Yeah, I think it's important that they focus on who they have as opposed to who they don't have, and it's great for these girls to be getting game time at this stage of the season, and you need that depth going into the World Cup. You know, we suffered ourselves in the semi-final of the World Cup having not had rested players, and England had a rotational policy going on for the first three games, so going into next season's World Cup, we need about 32 players all fighting for positions to get on those match day squads.
So England go to the tail. Cameron Roy gets a hand on that. Ambitious. I mean, it's quite a still day, so the tail of the line is an option, but almost surprising to see that from England there. Oh, and Lindsay, that's Kira Griffin taking that inside ball very nicely. Saved, it again goes wide. Naupu. And again, Murray Coyne is seeing a lot of the ball. It's Cliona Maloney taking that one in. England trying to strip it in the tackle. Skip ball that time from Nora Stapleton. Paula Fitzpatrick finds Fowley. Alison Miller. Ooh, nearly away, but not quite. Still in play though. And again, Ireland been looking very comfortable with ball in hand.
I'm just really encouraged the width that they're holding constantly as they go through the phases, that they're getting enough people in the rucks in the middle of the field, but still the space out here on the wing with players out here as well.
It's really nice hands there from Mary Louise Riley. A little offload in the tackle. Sending it up, but not quite finding with the over-the-shoulder boulder. Stapleton. Again, it's Claire Malloy. Takes two to Downer, and again she makes some good yardage. Stapleton, Paula Fitzpatrick. Nope, in for two assist. But again, Ireland have conceded a penalty. Not releasing after the tackle.
It's good to see Niamh Kavanagh back on the pitch again. She's had two tough years of injury, and to work her way back has been tough for her, but it's great to see her out there playing number 14 again.
So again, most of the play remaining in around the halfway and 10-metre lines, but England have a decent opportunity here to win a line out and establish a decent position. Fleetwood again going, not quite to the tail, but taken by Sarah Hunter, but knocked on.
Great pressure there from Claire Malloy coming through the line out. It was a bad ball down to the scrum half, but Claire Malloy was up to snaffle any danger out.
So Nora Stapleton passing the instructions out the back line. Ireland not really going for any kind of kicking game so far. So Larissa Muldoon, it's again another solid Irish scrum. It's Patrick away, Muldoon. Nope on the dummy run. Looks, and that's Fowley. Coyne throws the dummy. Well taken there by Claire Allen. Paula Fitzpatrick again.
Great line speed there from England.
Stapleton, very flat. Mary Shee again, Lindsay Peake. Good hands from the front row, the entire front row there as Fiona Maloney takes it on. But the English backline are regrouping, realigning very well each time, and Ireland have been faced with the full white wall. Claire Malloy again. This time Stapleton goes to the kick. Finds a good touch just outside the 22.
Yeah, good choice by Nora to go for the kick. They weren't getting much change out of that English defence. You know, they'd make a break, but then they'd be pushed back 5 metres. So to get in behind them there with a nice little kick.
So a chance for Ireland to apply a bit of pressure on the English throw here, as they did the last one. Again, they go for the tails, picked off by Claire Malloy. It looked slightly crooked as well, but it's been given as a knock-on by against Ireland there.
Yeah, there seems to be a bit of confusion in the English line-out. Obviously, the throw was the back. There was a jump by Sarah Hunter, but there was no lift there. You would think that England would just want to simplify things a little in their line-out just to make sure that they...
Very unusual on your own 22 to be thrown into the tail like that.
Well, I suppose they're trying to keep it away from Maz Riley in the middle of the, in the middle of the park, but a little bit of movement maybe or shorten line-out just to make sure that you secure it.
So, Natoya Mason defeat. Bit of a slight nudge on by Ireland there, but it's quickly moved off the base by England. Bringing Kay Wilson off the wing. That's a good kick by the English centre, Allen there. Ray Coyne under pressure here. Let's go over just before being bundled into touch, but it's touched nonetheless.
Yeah, it worked out to be a good kick by Scott. She was under a little bit of pressure when she got the ball, but it all came down to that good chase from Claire Allen and Danielle Waterman. Again, it's great to see referee Amy Parrott over here from Australia, you know, giving her the exposure at these big games and the lead into a World Cup. It's a big year for the referees as well.
So England go over to the front that time. It's still a bit scrappy, but well taken by Tamara Taylor on the wrap. No change there for England, looking to roll it around, use that big pack. Maz Riley in on the tackle there. That's a nice left-handed pass there from Scott. Claire Allen wrapped up. Marley Parker taking that one on. Referee has indicated a penalty there, I think. Claire Malloy scrapping away, holding that up. The referee is going to go back for a penalty, a high tackle. Can't say that I noticed that myself.
I suppose anything higher than the shoulders is a high tackle these days, so could have been a bit of an innocuous one from our point of view.
So a chance for England to get into the Irish 22, really, for the first time.
Yeah, there's been a bit of a lack of fluidity in England's attack. It's been a bit stop-start. You know, their back line got a good ball there and then a penalty, so it'd be good to see what they could do off phase play.
If they can win their own line-out ball, which has been a bit of a struggle for them. Interesting to see where they go with this one. They go for Taylor at four, and she takes it well. That's solid. England looking to roll it around. This is where they scored a couple of tries against the French off line-out mauls. But Ireland organised, and England not getting much purchase there. But they're sticking at it, and there they go. Scott, that's a super hit by Sinead Niopu on Rachel Burford there. Can hear the collisions from here. Oh, that's a super hit again. The Irish defence up very quickly. Nora Stapleton hit hard in turn. A sniff of a half chance there. Stapleton could have got that one away. Muldoon down the line. It's taken by the English winger again. That's good chasing by Alison Miller, who's over on the right wing. A long way from home. Hop back inside well by England. Fowley with the tackle. Rochelle Clark, Lindsay Pete. It was a good clash there between the two number ones. Scott goes wide, and that's an interesting looking ball. Can just Fiona or Rachel Burford not quite able to get her mitts on that one before it goes into touch. But it's a penalty to Ireland.
An interesting call. I didn't actually see what happened there.
Oh, trying to see what I think what it could be, given the position 15 metres in suggests almost a line out. Infringement. I don't think it was offside. Answers by text, viewers.
The Irish line speed has been absolutely excellent. That it's allowing us to make those big hits through Sene Nupu and Nicole Fowley in that last phase of play. You know, they're really eager to get off the line. It's just really important that they keep a cohesiveness in that line, that they don't leave any gaps on the inside to allow England play the ball back on the inside.
So Ireland survived that first period of any kind of pressure, really. And again, solid line out. Maz Riley takes. Stapleton now, Alison Miller off her left wing. And it's a little bit loose, but taken by Mairead Coyne. And she makes good yardage. Stapleton again, Claire Malloy in the midfield. Dancing feet again. It's an injury to
Mairead Coyne.
Mairead Coyne, yes. Newport, nice hands. Lindsay Pete, Mairead Coyne just been attended to off the ball here and regaining her feet as that's popped backwards from Claire Malloy. I think that was off a knee, so Ireland been a bit scrappy with the ball here, but retaining it, and in the end it's a penalty against England for side entry.
Ireland are getting good ball, but it was fractionally quicker at the ruck time. We have space out wide. You know, England are still defending quite narrow, but they've been allowed that time to sort the defence out because the ruck ball isn't quick enough for Ireland.
Stapleton again, not quite managing to find touch of that, but it's knocked on by the English left wing there, Fiona Pocock.
Yeah, Nora will be disappointed with those two kicks that didn't go find touch. You know, that's really, really important. It did work out, but, you know, you'd be 10 metres further up the pitch with your own line out if she had found touch. Yeah, we're hearing there's big queues to get in here in UCD. You know, going forward for next week, all those tickets are online on ticketmaster.ie, so to stop you queuing, buy your tickets online.
And a word actually on parking, because it's a bit of a walk now from the car park. You allow yourself an extra 5 minutes there.
Or use public transport.
So 25 minutes gone, still nil all. There's been no chance of a try or even a shot at goal as yet. But Ireland, Tom Tierney would be fairly happy with the way things have gone. That scrum was under a bit of pressure, but holding well. Paul Fitzpatrick allows Russell Muldoon to get it away. And that's a brilliant break. Niamh Kavanagh on a return. Great burst there from her. And Ireland look to go wide again. Fowley, Coyne, Alison Miller. All down, just inside the 22. Good feet there from Nora Stapleton to avoid the onrushing Marley Parker. It looked like she was going to flatten her for a second. Good position from Ireland now. On the 22. Deciding to go back blind. Mairead Coyne again taking it on. Stapleton, it's a bit static though. Claire Malloy adding to it. Quick ball now, and they have numbers on the right if they can get it, but it's a little bit slower than they'd want again. Stapleton pops back inside. Paula Fitzpatrick. Maz Riley taken there by Taylor, I think it was. Pop back inside to Sene Nupo. But again, it's been slowed down and that ball popped back inside to Ailish Egan. Ball in play a long time here, but Ireland not actually getting any yards out of it. And As Nora Stapleton takes that one going back, it's a good take. That looks forward. Niamh Kavanagh looks like she's got away with that. Again, good running from Niamh. Muldoon pops that side to Fowley, takes it into traffic. And have an injured player down there. And in the end, after all of that, give away a penalty.
Yeah,
about
look,
30 yards behind where they had the ball a minute ago.
This is where it kind of all started, and it was encouraging play from Ireland. You know, Niamh Kavanagh off the line out through the middle. We spun it wide, but then we didn't make any ground after that. You know, we have to punch through the middle, but it all comes from fast ruck. Our ruck ball is too slow. You know, it's allowing England to realign in the defence and come up hard.
I thought the microphone was in danger there for a second. You were getting a bit agitated watching some of that.
Yeah, I just, you know, if we speed up, if Ireland speed up the ruck ball, the space is there out wide, you know, but we're too slow in the middle of the park getting the ball away from the ruck. And that's two things. That's England slowing our ball down, but it's also us not blowing past the ruck. You know, hopefully Niamh Kavanagh's okay there now. She's down injured. Two big ball carries from her, you know, first time on the ball in 2 years at international level, and she made ground on both of them. So hopefully she gets up out of that and she's looking good. Definitely Ireland's attack is looking a bit more creative than England's, but it's the gain line and where you end up at the end of the day when the whistle blows, and unfortunately we're going to be back down in our own half with England's penalty here.
Yeah, it has to be said, England's defence has been very solid.
It has, considering that there's space out wide, but we're giving them far too much time to realign and make the tackles out wide.
So Emily Scott will go down the line, fine touch. Just outside, halfway between the 22 and the 10-metre line.
Yeah, the last line out they used, Tamara Taylor at the front in quite a congested area, and that's tough for the hooker to pick out a jumper right in the middle between Ireland's two and four defensive jumpers. So I think England need a bit more movement in their line out. They've gone for the shortened option, which is probably a wise decision.
Yeah.
Probably looking to hit Marley Packer or Izzy Noel-Smith out in the back line.
Bit more movement there, right on cue, as Sarah Hunter took that one. Marley Packer takes it into a congested midfield. Kira Griffin, Claire Malloy in on the tackle, trying to hold it up but not quite able to do that. Oh, and that's half break, and it's popped off to Vicky Fleetwood. England's best position so far. Scott goes wide. Oh, and that should have been given by the English fullback Waterman. That was a try on the cards there. The desperate defence by Ireland now. England on the line. It's collapsed there. Amy Perrott goes in to inspect. And it'll be an English scrum 5 metres out.
Yeah, that just shows what England can do off good line-out ball and hitting Marley Packer through the centre. And then Vicky Fleetwood is a hugely dynamic player at hooker and, you know, good gain line made of her. But a brilliant tackle, I think, was by Mairead Coyne to hold her out. But England will be killing themselves. They had a three-man overlap if they snapped back on the right-hand side and had an overlap on the left-hand side if the ball had been given.
Daniel Waterman should have given the pass. No two ways about it.
I wouldn't imagine Fee Pocock is too happy with her at the moment. But look, split-second decisions, and I suppose we have a better vantage view than the players on the pitch.
We don't really have to stick our heads out of the box to see the corner. So, big scrum here. First key moment of the game, really, after 30 minutes. Latoya Mason giving the signal by Amy Perrott. Muldoon and Mason have a right ding-dong as Muldoon tries to get in. Rachel Hunter or Sarah Hunter takes it, but no ground made. They recycle though, and that's, oh, it's a big hit. Sending an oopo, that was huge. Again though, England right on the line, pop back inside, and that's going to be in. Marley Packer in for the first score of the game. No, it's forward. Well, Amy Perrott was right on the spot there, in fairness to her, but in real time, looking at it from this angle, I can't say that I picked it up.
I suppose it is the angle that you're standing at, and she's right there. A brilliant line from Marley Packer. Again, another dynamic player. You don't want running down your channel, but Ireland now, let's look at their exit strategy from a scrum inside, deep inside their own 22. But again, another huge hit from Senny Nupu. I suppose we saw it last season in the Six Nations and seen it again here today. It's not just the line speed, it's the line speed and the follow through after that.
Yeah, lost to the club game here. She's obviously gone to England with George moving to Harlequins.
Yeah, she's playing for Aylesford Bulls there, so a few of her teammates here. I don't know how much rugby she's actually played.
Paul Fitzpatrick picks it off the base. That's good dynamic running there to earn a little extra space for the clearance.
Yeah, it's tough. The scrum was up the wrong way. It was wheeled up left. Paula had a tough job to do to come around right. It probably would have been better if she'd taken the ball around left.
That's a good clearing kick from Nora Stapleton. So, crisis averted for the time being. Rocky Clark going in to have a chat with Vicky Fleetwood as to where this one's going to go. It's towards the tail, taken by Hunter. England again looking to get a bit of momentum on that line-out maul. Ireland countering well. Again, Fleetwood though, dynamic you said, Fiona, she certainly is. Again, Ireland defending desperately now, just 5-6 metres out from their own line. On, that's in. Try scored on the blind side. Get the number now.
Rocky Clark.
It's Rocky Clark, of all people.
What a day, what a day for her. First try, 115 caps. You know, and it was good. It was off again, England securing line-out ball, mauling it, Vicky Fleetwood off the back, and then a pick and go. You know, it's nearly all a little bit too easy for England doing that when Ireland have held them out for so long.
So there's an injury to Ireland here into the bargain. Can't quite make out who it is from here just yet.
Kira Griffin, maybe.
It doesn't look very promising. You never like to see the attendant lying down like that alongside it. Suggests it could be serious.
Trying to work it out from their boots, yellow boots. It's now how Ireland come back from this. You know, I suppose it's been pretty evenly matched throughout. Ireland looking with a little bit more endeavour and attack, and then England come away with a score. So it's go back down here, kick off, and keep England down here and not let them back in before half time.
So the conversion not successful there from Emily Scott, but that is a serious looking injury now as the stretcher unit is on.
Cliona Maloney, possibly. I'm just trying to figure out who's standing. Possibly Cliona Maloney, hooker.
Yes, by process of elimination there.
Interesting on the bench. Ireland don't have an out-and-out hooker. It'll be interesting to see who comes on. Leah Lyons could come on there. She has played predominantly as prop. She'd be coming on for her first cap of Oz. You know, definitely skillful enough, has thrown the ball in the line out for Munster over the years.
The good news is that she's up on her feet. It is indeed Cliona Maloney. So stretcher is going to be used, but it doesn't look as serious as it may have done.
Yeah, so here's Leah Lyons coming on to win her first cap for Moy originally, then moved to Highfield. Hugely skillful player, very clever player, new into the Irish squad this year. Again, lots of potential. She will be playing out of position, but I've no doubt she is good enough to play there.
So after 35 minutes, we've had a breakthrough for England. They lead 5-0. And it came fairly easily in the end once they got into that position. So England sorted off that restart, but not. That's a poor pass from Mason on that occasion. Ireland can't really get in top of it though. That's a good offload. That's Harriet Miller-Mills, I think, taking that one on. But that's robbed by Ireland. Well done, Ciara Griffin. Claire Malloy. Again, the dancing feet. Might have been a chance to go wide, actually, on that one, though.
Yeah, normally off turnover, they'd be looking for two passes, but Claire, I suppose Claire backs her dancing feet every time.
Maybe she can take that one in. The crowd begin to find their voice and offers them backing. First touch now for Leah Lyons. Stapleton, Malloy again. Playing almost like a centre. Oh, that was a burst there from Nicole Fowley that looked like I had a bit of potential, but ultimately England given a penalty against them for hands in the ruck. So Stapleton with another chance to go down the line here. Build a position for Ireland. That's a better kick from her. Build a position for Ireland as we come towards the tail end of this first half.
Yeah, this is a really good attacking position for Ireland now, just outside England's 22. You know, simple line out, nearly maul it up a bit, create some space for the backs, and then look for them to have a cut at it. Ireland going for a six-man line out.
Oh, that's picked off at the front by Harriet Miller-Mills there. Rocky Clark takes that one in. Yeah, Marley Packer, solid defending there. Ailish Egan into the tackle. Scott kicks deep. Coyne will take that. Helps to run back. That's makes an extra 5 yards in contact there very well. Paul Fitzpatrick taking that one in. Leah Lyons carrying well since she's come in. Stapleton going wide, there's space there. And we'll find touch just 6-7 meters out from the English line.
Yeah, that was a brilliant phase of play. You know, collected superbly by Mairead Coyne, and she made extra ground on it, hit it up through the middle, present for Nora, and a great kick into the corner. However, on the last line-out that Ireland had, it was a disappointing choice of line-out. You know, it's a really difficult line-out thrown to that three position to where Paula Fitzpatrick was standing, and puts your hooker under huge pressure, and England just nicked it off at the front.
So can England have reduced this one just to four? Bit of movement. But that's well snaffled but gone forward off. That was an opportunity there to nick that one. Is he Noel Smith taking that one in? Lindsay Pete in on the tackle. And the pressure tells in the end.
Well, Ian, I think it was Ailish Egan in there over the ruck. Yeah, that's a brilliant turnover by Ailish. You know, great chance for Ireland now to get some points on the board. I think England probably tried to overplay it out in this 22. You know, they probably should just look to hit it up and then kick it out.
Exactly, a minute to go. Why take the chance? Of course, Ireland without Niamh Briggs, their normal place kicker, Nora Stapleton.
Yeah,
taking on the duty.
Nora would be well experienced as well, kicking for club and province, and then any time that Niamh wasn't on the pitch, which was very rarely in the past, but Nora would have taken over kicking duties as well.
I suspect this is the first time an Irish team has had an all Donegal halfback partnership. You don't get that too often. Nora Stapleton, Julie slots it over to reduce the deficit. Just 2 points, 5, England 5, Ireland 3. As we enter injury time at the end of the first half. So that means Scott to restart. That's Marty Parker was ahead of the kicker there, but has got away with it. And that's well taken by Fiona Quocock. Clever there from Paula Fitzpatrick, not buying the tip on pass, drifting with it and making the hit. Leah Lyons, oh, offside, giving against her.
That was a superb take from Fee Pocock out here on the wing. You know, a couple of players were offside, but Fee started right behind Emily Scott. Great chase. A bit naive by Ireland not to attack the ball, but brilliant by Fee Pocock.
So Wigan will get a late chance to add to the score. Nope. But she has missed that. Penalty is going to go dead. Badly sliced as Amy Perrott blows the whistle for half time. Five, England 5, Ireland 3. Not a lot in it. Fiona's been able to come into the second half.
No, definitely. Both evenly matched teams on every facet of the play. You know, I think Ireland were a bit more creative at times. But you give England a sniff and they'll get back into the game. So it'll be see who comes out firing at the start of the second half.
So join us again in a few minutes for the second half. We'll see you then.
chance to be part of rugby history. There's the first try. Scarlett, he's going to go all the way.
It's okay, I'm good.
We bring the stars out, we bring the women and the cars and the cars out. Let's have a toast and celebration, get a glass out. And we can do this until we pass out.
It's a brilliant try for the Irish.
Yeah.
We won't come down until we hit the ground.
Yeah, pass out. Yeah, I'm in charge now. I'm a star and I brought my cars down. I live a very, very, very wild lifestyle. Heidi and Audrina, eat your heart.
It'll bring memories of past glories. It'll bring new heights of belief and ambition. It'll bring the boldest hopes and the bravest dreams. It'll bring everyone to their feet. It'll bring a roar into every voice. It'll bring this great game into a nation's heart. It'll bring the world to us and us to the world. Women's Rugby World Cup, Ireland, August 2017. Bring it.
So welcome back to the Belfield Bowl for the second half of Ireland versus England of this November international series. England lead 5-3. There's been a slight change in the conditions in that it's drizzling slightly. It's kind of misty rain. So that may have an impact on the handling. I'm just looking around to see if there are any changes on the England team. We know there are no changes on the Irish team.
Yeah, England have a huge amount of experience to come off the bench. The likes of Mo Hunt and Katie McLean. You know, that would add to their 9-10 combo, but I'm sure that Simon Middleton wants to give the likes of Mason and Emily Scott time together, you know, to develop them going forward. It was brilliant to see there at halftime a team from each of the provinces, underage team playing out there, you know, to see young girls playing under 13s, under 15s. It just bodes well for the future, and it's hugely encouraging of what the Irish women's team have done over the last number of years, to see girls playing at that age.
It certainly is. Unbridled enthusiasm on the pitch at halftime. There was great as Ireland retake the field.
You know, there's a good crowd here today, probably 1,000 people or so, and hopefully that'll build as the season goes on next week against Canada, and then as we welcome New Zealand here, and hopefully we can do the same again as what we did in 2014 against New Zealand, and then leading into the Six Nations, and then home World Cup for the Irish girls.
Yes, the biggest year in Irish women's rugby history ahead of us.
Yeah, and I suppose the pool draw the other day kind of brought it home to a lot of girls that it's not that far away, and now they know who they're playing. They can have one eye on that, but keep the other eye on a lot of rugby to play between now and then.
And what did you make of that draw? Ireland are in the pool with France, Australia, and a qualifier from Asia, Oceania.
Yeah.
Which pitches the 4, 5, and 6 teams in the world in one pool?
Yeah, I think... you know, every pool is difficult, and the format, the competition, it's difficult to get out of your pool. I think before the draw, if you told me we'd get France, I would have been happy with that. Australia, you know, we don't know a lot about them, but again, the way they've been going, you probably would bet your chances against them. But when it comes down to World Cup in 9 months' time, you can't write anyone off. Ireland were third-ranked team in their pool 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm. So Tamara Taylor taking that one in, but England fall foul of the referee again for holding on after the tackle.
Claire Malloy and Kira Griffin working great in the back row there to get in and turn over that ball.
Yeah, for back rows, they're both relatively low to the ground, actually, so their body shape's going to help them in terms of competing on the deck like that.
And they're an absolute nuisance in the ruck, both of them. You know, I suppose that's probably one of the strengths of their game. If they get in there, you know, there's no moving them at all. That was a good touch finder from Nora Stapleton. Here we see Leah Lyons now with her first throw.
So again, she's not a frontline hooker, so it's asking quite a bit of her stepping into this. But that's a fine throw. Maz Riley takes well.
Yeah, that was
Ireland actually worked that around, get a bit of momentum on the rolling ball. Penalty to Ireland for an England infringement there. I think not wrapping around to come joining from behind.
Yeah, I'm not sure who's calling Ireland's lineouts, but that was clever. You know, it was hitting Maz, but going forward slightly, so it wasn't too difficult to throw, just to get Leah into the game a little bit and give her a bit of confidence on her first throw. And a great maul off that puts them into even better position now with that penalty.
Oh, and that is just found touch, but a very good one once it did make it in.
Yeah, like again, Nora kicking for touch. You know, it's probably the area of the game that's letting her down a bit at the moment. She's playing very well, but she has to nail them. It worked out well in the end, but, you know, if that had been caught, we would have been in a different situation.
So an early opportunity for Ireland to put some pressure on the English throw deep in their own territory. Oh, sorry, Irish lined out, of course, off the penalty. And that time it's picked off by Harriet Miller-Mills taking that one, but bundled into touch and it'll be an Irish lineout.
That was the same lineout that we called up in a good position in the first half. That ball to the three area where Paula's standing, it just haven't worked. It's a very congested area. Paula's not the tallest, and England are just marking her out of it. Ireland really looked to use Maz Riley, which has been effective, or use someone where there's a bit more movement, someone coming around from the back or moving from the front to the back to create the space.
That balance. You can't hit Maz with every one of them because it just becomes too predictable.
But it's working.
But when you got somebody 6'4" in there.
It is, and England are giving her the space to actually get it, and that was actually a good throw from Leah Lyons as well.
So Muldoon. Nora Stapleton takes it up the line, sending it to Upu. Oh, it's knocked forward in the tackle from her. They scrum to England, and that was disappointing from a promising position.
Yeah, that's the first mistake from Nicole Fowley today in her first cap. You know, encouraging, good line out. Nora hit the line really flat and then looked to play Nicole a bit flat as well. Probably under a little bit of pressure there. The defence were up hard as well.
Yeah. It's a get another injury timeout here. It's an English player. Can't quite make out which one it is.
So this is going to be England's scrum in their 22. They really, their last exit strategy from the 22 in the first half was disappointing on their behalf, and they turned over the ball, which gave the penalty to Ireland. You know, it's they need a good scrum. They need to probably hit it up once or twice and then kick out of this danger zone.
Mm-hmm. So you doing anything interesting tonight?
I'm actually have the pleasure of attending the World Rugby Awards, so very much running off to for a flight after this.
Any official capacity?
I'm not quite sure yet.
Oh, you're not. I thought you were presenting the award for the Women's Rugby World Player of the Year.
Yeah, I probably will make it on stage at some point.
Yeah, mine is Sunday night and nothing quite as glamorous as that. Big night for Irish rugby with Jamie Heaslip up for shortlisted for rugby for World Player of the Year and also for Try of the Year.
Yeah, Jamie's had a brilliant season. You know, he's been consistent for Ireland throughout. He does a lot of the hard work that he doesn't get a credit for a lot of the time. So it's great to see him being recognised on world level.
So big scrum this one. Again, Muldoon. It's a great little battle there at scrum half. She pesters her opposite number, but England take that one around the side. Vicky Fleetwood again. She does look very dynamic every time she gets ball in hand, doesn't she? Well, that's an injury again to...
It's Claire Malloy, I think, is it?
Yes, looks like Claire Malloy. And I think it might be shoulder she was reaching for there. So it's a bit of a stop-start to this second half, with a few injuries.
Yeah, it'd be obviously huge for Ireland if Claire Malloy was to come off. You know, she really is one of Ireland's top players over the last number of years, world-class seven. Again, another player who doesn't necessarily get the credit for all the work that she does on the pitch, and normally anything good that comes out of Ireland's play, both in attack or defence, starts with Claire Malloy.
Yeah, she's hugely dynamic, and you've mentioned dancing feet a couple of times. She's a great player to watch.
Yeah, it's probably Chloe Pearce or Katie Norris. I would imagine Chloe Pearce might come on for her first cap.
So what do you think Tom Tierney would have been saying to his charges at halftime?
Yeah, I would imagine it would speed up that ruck ball because the space is there when we get it. Probably play a bit more positioning. You know, there's been a lot around the middle of the park just to look for that space in behind England and put pressure on them with a kick chase.
Yeah, because Nora Stapleton has put in a couple of nice kicks to the corner. Ireland have done well out of that when she's tried it. We've tried nothing up in the air, actually.
Yeah, I don't know whether that's a tactic or not, but it's always good to challenge a back three in the air to see what they're at. And, you know, if they're confident, they take it well, fair enough, you learn from that, but we haven't tried it.
So Claire Malloy back on her feet, but her elbow is wrapped up in her jersey and it looks highly unlikely she's going to continue.
Yeah, Chloe Pearce on for her first cap. Huge day for her and for you elbows, her club. She originally started out with Shannon RFC and then moved to Elbows. Predominantly plays number 8 down the club, so it'll be interesting to see whether they play left and right or Ciara Griffin might move to her usual position of 7.
So again, England under a bit of pressure with the scrum underneath their own post. Okay, good driver by Ireland, but England come away with it. Senna Nupo makes the tackle on Danielle Waterman. Crowd giving Claire Malloy a huge ovation as she goes off in front of the stand. As England look to come out. Yeah, in England, reluctant to clear, and then when they do try to kick it, it's blocked down. But England regathered Sarah Hunter,
Yeah, but great work.
Given.
Great work by Kira Griffin, you know, she blocked down the ball and then Lindsay Peake cleans it up there. England are probably overplaying it in their own 22. Yeah. You know, I know they're looking to get a bit of time for Emily Scott to clear it, but then it was a box kick under pressure from Latoya Mason and was well blocked down. But this is time again, you know, you think they would have learned from the first half when they were under pressure and now they're doing the exact same thing and put Ireland in a really good attacking position.
Yeah, they seem to have opportunities to clear it before, and when they did take the opportunity to clear, they were did so under pressure, so it's strange. Good bit of attacking position though for Ireland here. There is some Muldoon to feed. Oh, but that's popped back out the tunnel, it will be reset. Thought I'd snaffle that one against the head for a second.
You know, the last scrum from Ireland was really good. It put England under pressure and gave it them a little bit of a nudge going backwards. And we seem to be getting lower than them in the scrum, but make sure we do it on our ball as well when the hooker is striking.
And good scrum by Ireland. It's solid. It's Patrick Muldoon. Alison Miller off a wing. Makes good yards. Quick ball needed now. It's reasonably quick. Maz Riley under the post. Ireland have numbers right. Paul Fitzpatrick taking it on, just 4 metres from the line now. Again, Ireland continue right. And this pressure wins them a couple of yards. Penalty, arm out from Mary Parrott. And we will go back for that because it's been a knock on. England not rolling away.
Yeah, really good scrum, really strong scrum. Larissa Muldoon runs across and Ali Miller comes back in on the switch and then we hit up a few times through the forwards and, you know, putting England under huge pressure that they give away a penalty.
So North Stapleton will knock this into touch. No, she won't. Paul Fitzpatrick deciding we'll have a scrum, thanks.
Yeah, I think that's a bit of confidence from the last scrum that they had. And, you know, in this position, that's a good call. You know, the line-out has been under a little bit of pressure and probably not getting the change they thought they would, so they're going for a scrum.
So, good position this. And, in fact, in the 7 minutes or so of the second half, it's been All-Ireland.
Yeah, pretty much like the start of the first half as well. It was all Ireland. It's now capitalising on this position and making sure we don't come away from here with something without something.
Good options here. They've got a 15-metre blindside to work here, if they choose.
I have to say the ball retention today has been a lot better by both England in particular, who it was quite poor the other night against France, and France were poor as well. So the ball retention in now wet conditions that we have here in UCD has been a lot better.
Again, another injury timeout. It's been very staccato second half. Big word for broken up there.
We saw last night the Canadian women's team are already in town. They were out supporting their men's team in the Aviva last night, as were the Irish team. You know, they have a nice stint here before they play Ireland next weekend. And then they play New Zealand in Donnybrook on the Wednesday following that. So lots of rugby to play in and around UCD and Donnybrook over the next 3 weeks.
Yeah, I think a lot of people may not be aware that Canada are actually the number two women's team.
Yeah, Canada were brilliant at the World Cup 3 years ago, but they backed that up in the Summer Series. They won the Summer Series there this year as well out in America. And, you know, they play some scintillating rugby and have brilliant players. So, you know, I think they'll be a stern test for Ireland as well.
So finally we get going with the scrum, and it's a solid, powerful scrum. Ireland marching forward. Penalty to Ireland signalled. If they play advantage, they may go all the way though here. No, blown up.
That's brilliant, you know.
Alison Muldoon looked at maybe going quickly, but in the circumstances, you want to take this scrum again, don't you?
Yeah, definitely. That was a big call by Paul Fitz, and, you know, huge confidence in that pack to push them over again. And it's really, really important that they get a good, solid scrum again and justify that call.
And perhaps it should be noted that actually the forward eight that's on the pitch now is actually bigger than the one starting. But, you know,
Leah Lyons and Chloe Pierce would add a little extra there. So Ireland again. England just holding that up. And that ball pops out. Muldoon, Stapleton has a look herself. Chloe Pierce takes it on. This is terrific position again from Ireland.
Give it.
Lindsay Peart. Again, they continue going down the left-hand side. We'll go back, change direction now. Ailish Egan this time. And it's stripped by Harriet Miller-Mills, but only into the arms of Nora Stapleton. Has she gone all the way? She has, you know. Brilliantly opportunistic score from Nora Stapleton there. Just when it looked like, actually Tamara Taylor was, that stripped it. But it went forward, Stapleton picked it up, showed some quick feet and dived over.
Yeah, just when you thought Ireland were going to come away with nothing, you know, brilliant by Nora, brilliant footwork by her and a brilliant individual try. Originally the sustained pressure came from a really strong scrum, which we looked to get a bit high on. We had go forward in it, but we were a little bit high that we didn't keep going. Came out wide, we thought we'd lost the opportunity, and then Nora to dance through for that try.
So that brings it to Ireland 8, England 5 with the conversion to come. And it should be noted this would only be Ireland's third ever win against England if they were to pull it off today. So this is no small feat.
Yeah, I think the scoreline at the moment justifies the way that Ireland have been playing, and they've been on top most of the first half and at the start of the second half. We can see England subs warming up here now in Natasha Hunt and Katie McLean. I'm sure they've been brought on to kind of steady the ship a little bit and probably improve the decision making, particularly around that exit area in their own 22.
Nora Stapleton adds the extra two to her own try to make it Ireland 10, England 5.
Change in the Irish team as well. Larissa Muldoon comes off for Mary Healy to get a run. And again, this is so important that you have this depth and you have this competition for places as you're going into a World Cup year.
So both sides changing their scrum half. Latoya Mason being replaced by Natasha Hunt, as you suggested. Healy now, first touch. Griffin takes it on. Oh, England through in the person of Izzy Noel-Smith, but a bit early. Side entry.
It was a great take from Leah Lyons there that set it up, and then another hit through the middle. You know, it's important now that Nora gets this touch.
Oh, just.
Again, Ireland going for a short line-out. I think it could be a five-man line-out with Chloe Pierce and Keira Griffin out here in the centres.
So Leah Lyons to throw. Bit of forward and back from Miles Riley. That's a well-worked line-out. Nice hands from Stapleton as well. Again, Griffin punches it up. That's quicker ball from Ireland. Oh, looks like a high tackle on Mairead Coyne there. Parrott's arm is out. As Mary Healy knocks that one into touch, but they will come back for the penalty so that Ireland should get the throw into the line-out.
Yeah, that was another good line-out call there. You know, a bit of movement in it, but then going to the front and giving Leah Lyons that easy throw. High tackle there, but clever play by Mary Healy, looking for that space in behind, you know, to get in behind the English team.
So Nora Stapleton works out and finds a
Good touch there, actually, on the 32. Yeah, there was an audible intake of breath, though. She's dicing with that.
Yeah, I don't know whether Nora's changed her style of kicking for touch slightly, but she doesn't seem to be getting as much distance as she did in the past, which is fine if that's something the process she's going through, that she's changing her kick and she needs to use these games to see how it's going and make adjustments from that.
So Ireland have done well since scoring the try to begin to reapply a bit more pressure. That throw is a bit ropey, but Ada Sheehan takes it well at the tail. But referee Amy Parrott's arm goes up in the air, not releasing penalty to England.
Yeah, I wouldn't necessarily blame the throw on that one. There was no lift on the jump ball. If it's Simon seemed to jump, but there was no lift there. So I don't know whether it was a miscommunication that they didn't know where it was to go. But a bit of cleaned up by Eilish in the end, but that's not really a good platform, and we got a turnover.
Because nobody else was expecting her to get it. So contested well there by Ireland. Forced the knock on. It was Tamara Taylor who took it initially, but again under pressure from Ireland the knock on came. England warming up another couple of substitutions. Looks like Vicky Cornborough and Justine Lucas will come in.
Yeah, so this English side is interesting. So England have their elite player system with a number of players now contracted, full-time contracted, and from January they're going to have part-time contracted and then some players who are on short-term contracts. So come January they're going to be pretty much professional outfit, a lot of training time together. And we saw in 2014 the difference that made between Six Nations 2014 and World Cup 2014. The amount of the cohesiveness in their squad come the World Cup time, it was key for them.
So Laura Keats coming off, being replaced by Justine Lucas. And And Rocky Clark also has come off to bring an end to her record-breaking number of English caps, 115th cap today. So Mary Healy feeds again, another solid Irish scrum, putting England under pressure. And that's Niamh Kavanagh off the wing. Stapleton opts for the boot on this occasion, the space there. That's a fine kick. Finally touched deep inside the English 22.
Yeah, a strong scrum and absolutely brilliant inch-perfect kick there from Nora Stapleton. You know, and that's what we've been looking for Nora to do, get in behind that English team and put us in a really strong position. And we know England have had trouble with their exit strategies, so see what they can do and put them under pressure here.
So safely gathered by Harriet Miller Mills.
A bit disappointing that Ireland didn't contest that line out, you know, particularly in the position of the pitch that we're in.
Well, that's bouncing loose and well taken in the end by Alison Miller.
I said a slight knock on by England, but referee didn't see it.
And again, look to put some width on it. Naupo pops it back into Fowley coming back inside. Mary Healy, Niamh Kavanagh on the burst. Powerful runner, Niamh Kavanagh, isn't she?
Yeah, that's her strength. She's a big, strong runner. You know, she mightn't have the out-and-out speed of a winger, but she'll do a really strong job for you.
And that is a fairly spectacular case of offside. As she quizzically looks at the referee, who, me? As she played scrum half for Ireland.
Yeah, that's poor ill discipline from Amy Cocan.
Cocan, I'm calling her cocaine. She's giving England a lift. Boom, boom.
You know, this put Ireland back into another really good attacking position.
Yeah, another injury. Timeout. Very stop start the second half in particular. Can you make out who that is from here?
No. Ailish Egan possibly, is it?
Possibly. Looks to be a leg injury. But again, another great opportunity now for Nora Stapleton to go down the line and put some real pressure on England. You feel that one more score might be the clincher here.
Yeah, England have really lacked any sort of creativity when they've had the ball.
In fairness, second half they haven't had much
true
ball in hand. When they've had it, it's been deep in their own 22. So Stapleton finds a good safe touch. And a really good opportunity to set up a rolling ball, one would think, from this. That's good pressure from England, but Ireland have won it and are charging forward. Paula Fitzpatrick with that stripped in the tackle. It was Rachel Burford making the run. Kick clear, that's a tricky one for Murray Coyne. It's going to come back to England. They have numbers here on the short side, but Irish centres Mary Healy and Sandy Newbrook closing that gap. Danielle Waterman showing good feet there to escape from the clutches of Nicole Fowley. Good hit there on Sarah Hunter. Oh, knocked down again by England. And they really are struggling to get out of their own territory.
Yeah, Katie McLean probably tried to force it a little bit there. You know, she had a good kick and a good kick chase, and then with the ball, she tried to force it a little bit.
Alison Miller hobbles back gingerly.
You know, I suppose it's still that transfer over from sevens into 15s, and they played a bit of club rugby, but probably nothing at this intensity of international 15s, so it might take a little bit of time to gel them back in. While a lot of the skill set is still the same, it's in more confined spaces.
As England had put a lot of straw in their seven side team, didn't they?
We haven't seen a lot of these players for the last 2 years. Nolly Waterman, Mo Hunt, Katie McLean, you know, they've been off training full time with the sevens. And, you know, and I think England have brought up a lot of players in the last 2 years, which gives them this depth. But then to try and gel the girls back into 15s, it will take time.
It's another promising position here for Ireland. Again, the scrum has been rock solid all day. Oh, Fitzpatrick played that, and therefore the English scrum half could come around. Now, Vicky Fleetwood again showing fleet of foot. Oh, sending the upward, not quite getting there in time to prevent the pass being made. And England go wide for the first time in a long time. It's good pace, but great tackle by Murray Coyne. England look to punch up the middle, and that's a huge hit from Leah Lyons. Absolutely brilliant hit from Leah. But penalty to England, taken quickly. And that is a brilliant run from their replacement scrum half.
Flip back outside. Great chance here. Fleetwood, great hands. But referee has blown it back for a forward pass. And that was living by the seat of the pants by Ireland there. Good attacking play by England.
Brilliant by England. Huge big carry from Vicky Fleetwood down here. Movement by Katie McLean. Moved out wide. Feet Pocock with a brilliant run down the wing. Penalty and Mo Hunt at her best. Quick tap and making huge ground on it. And just an unfortunate forward pass for England there. Otherwise, I think we would have seen them in the corner.
A great break by, I think it was Natasha Hunt, replacement scrum half through the middle.
Yeah, she's renowned for those quick taps off those penalties. And, you know, it's something that you have to keep your eye on as an Irish player, because she will do it any chance she gets.
So suddenly from 10-5 ahead and pushing for a crucial score, Ireland hanging on a little bit and need to exit from this position.
Fiona Hayes coming on there for Lindsay Pete.
Elbows.
Yeah, she plays back row sometimes for UL Bows. She's a bit of a nuisance at the ruck time as well, and it's important that she gets this time in the front row to learn the dark arts of scrummaging. Or not so dark sometimes.
You know they're dark. Better than anybody. Oh, much better scrum from England. They've turned that over. Really promising position. Hunter breaks. Well, Griffin in with the tackle, did well there. Oh, was that knocked on? It was knocked on with the base, and that was a really promising position blown there by England.
Yeah, these are unforced errors that really aren't good enough by England, and, you know, they'd be very disappointed with it. They're pretty much inexcusable. You know, there was no pressure on there at the base of that ruck.
No, but given the last scrum, it's by no means certain that Ireland can clear the lines efficiently here. This is a big scrum. That's more solid by Ireland. Ball of Fitzpatrick. Nora Stapleton under pressure gets that away. And that's a super clearing kick from Nora. That's possibly our best kick of the day.
Yeah, again, another strong scrum from Ireland. You know, it was the previous one was Fee Hayes' first one in under a little bit of pressure, but she nailed it down there, and it was Ireland going forward. Great carry from Paula Fitz off the back. Nora under a slight bit of pressure, but a brilliant kick. Still in danger zone, though, if England can nail their line out and get this back line moving. We see Claire Allen's actually gone off, and Emily Scott moved to 13, which was obviously a good while ago when Katie McLean came on.
And once again, England go to the tail, but are unable to execute that successfully. Knocked on by England. Yeah, so Emily Scott has moved into the centre with Claire Allen off, as you say, yes.
I think England would be very disappointed with their line-out. Yeah, they are missing some of their line-out specialists like Abby Scott and Emily Braund, but still experience in there with the likes of Tamara Taylor.
Again, England applying some pressure, and that's messy, but and turned over, but penalty given against England. Not entirely sure what that was given for. It was for
those dark arts.
I think the signal was that it was driving up. But I wouldn't be 100% convinced.
So Ireland out of danger zone, but it's important now that they go down and play in England's half. So looking to hit it up and then maybe kick in behind England.
crowd on the far side getting into it, lending their support right in front of them. The dummy to Maz Riley, and that's taken by England at the tail. Again, Ireland causing their own problems there. Rachel Burford taking that one up. Oh, but cleverly snagged by Ireland to force the knock on. Ireland pick it up and have a chance to clear the lines. Sablin opting to run it. Kicked ahead. Daniel Waterman pops inside. England again look to go wide. And Pocock again, but this time good tackle made. Penalty against Ireland though for side entry, I think it was. England looking a bit more dangerous with ball on hand now.
Yeah, look, when they look to move the ball into space, they're obviously a very skillful team. You know, Fee Pocock coming in there and hitting up the middle, but I suppose they need to keep the ball and go through the phases.
Yet another injury. He doesn't count how many injuries that have been in the second half. I'd say we'll have a good 5 minutes of injury time.
I think this is going to be an excellent venue for Rugby World Cup. You know, it's really enclosed. I think the crowd will really get in and behind the teams that are playing here. And it's right in Dublin, so not too far to travel. So it's going to be great.
Yeah, it's just about the right size, isn't it?
Yeah, and the pitch is in great nick. Yeah. And it'll be summertime, so hopefully not too much rain that'll stay in that good condition.
Quite make out which English player it is there.
Be interested to see what England do here. Obviously their line out hasn't been functioning, but they will look for position as well. So you could see there straight away Mo Hunt was looking to take the quick tap but then chose not to, so probably will kick to the touchline.
Yeah, the certainties of the earlier part of this match are no longer so certain. The Irish scrum had been rock solid, but has been under a bit of pressure of late. The Irish line out has offered up one or two as well. So there are grounds for England to be encouraged here as the game enters the last 15 minutes or so. So Fleetwood to throw, goes short. Susie Noel-Smith takes it at the front there.
Fiona Hayes at her best there, pulling down a maul.
England just rolling it around, keeping it in tight. Great contesting there by Paula Fitzpatrick. Looking to hold it up and choke the tackle. And that's really cleverly done.
Brilliant by Ireland. You know, England looked so composed there that they were going to hit through the phases with the forwards. Sarah Hunter went in a little bit high and she was held up by brilliant Irish defence.
Because it looked like that was, you know, they had a couple of latchers on. It looked like they were just going to try and roll that slowly forward, use their power. But very clever defending by Ireland. More English substitutions coming on now. Poppy Cleal from Bristol and Kerry Large.
Yeah, Poppy Cleal's interesting enough. She played actually for the Irish Exiles 1 year, looking to get into the Irish squad and then was picked up by the English selectors.
Number 23, Kerry Clark. And number 5, Harriet Miller-Hill, 25 or 19,
It's interesting to look at the strength and condition of these teams. You know, in the past, England would have been so much more powerful than Irish teams, but the Irish girls have been on a two-year-long programme now, which has obviously shown its benefits in the fact that they're matching them for the length of the game, which is brilliant to see. You know, they went high performance, and as a result of that, they're in the gym throughout the year.
It is very noticeable to me, I suppose. I wouldn't see as much of women's rugby as you, obviously, but my preconception would be that England would be the more powerful, but it hasn't really borne out. Let's pop back out the tunnel. So Tom Tierney will be just looking for this to be clean, away quickly, cleared quickly. And, well, it will be cleared pretty quickly. This is a free kick to Ryan. Actually, Paula Fitzpatrick takes off, makes decent yardage, but penalised, holding on after the tackle.
Yeah, look, you can see what Paula's trying to do. She's trying to get a bit of momentum into the game, but now put us under huge pressure with England in a really good position.
So as we enter the last 10 minutes of normal time, England in a very strong position are gradually strangling the second half and potentially this match from Ireland's possession. Taken there at four by Tamara Taylor. Well, that's a good tackle. Nora Stapleton in on that. Going to go wide on the chip. Alison Miller under pressure, doesn't quite gather it, but it's actually going to come back for a penalty. Advantage was being played, but that was a dangerous situation. Ball bouncing around 5 metres from the Irish line. So Ireland survived that, but only to face another penalty for collapsing them all. So Ireland under serious pressure here. Line out to England, just 5 or 6 metres out.
Looks like Ireland are going to stay down and not contest the air. It's really important that they hit England immediately and not let them build up steam on them all.
Taylor again. England getting the momentum. Charging towards that line, they're going to go over. And yes, it is a try to England. I think was Izzy Noel-Smith coming up with the ball.
You know, good take in the line out, and immediately the momentum in the mall straight away. Ireland didn't have a chance. You know, question, if you go up in the air, Maz Riley did go up, but was that giving England too much time and not enough pressure on the ground? You know, and that's what they did so effectively on Wednesday against France. You know, two tries off the mall.
Yeah, and I hate to say it, but Ireland shooting themselves a little bit in the foot. They had the opportunity to clear. Paula took that quick tap, penalised, and the pressure was all back on Ireland. So it's a fine strike, and that's over for the lead.
Super strike by Katie McLean.
It certainly was. So, having dominated large portions of this match, Ireland find themselves 2 points down, 7 minutes of normal time remaining. There will be probably 5 minutes, I would think, of injury time.
Orla Fitz is after coming off there, and Katie Norris is getting a run.
Good pressure by Ireland.
That was brilliant in there by Fee Hayes.
Fee Hayes coming around side, yeah. Very sharp. But England have managed to hold on to it. So it's very slow, but eventually ball kicked deep. Ray Coyne. Stays in field well, supported by Paula Fitzpatrick. Here, Griffin, she needs support. It's not there quickly enough, but whoa. That was borderline, I thought. I'd say England feel a bit unhappy with that. They were in great body positions over that ball.
I think probably the tackler at the start didn't release, Katie McLean didn't release, and next player in was clear to go for it, but it was actually because Katie McLean didn't release. I say Mairead Coyne has been very solid under the high ball today. You know, anything that's been kicked at her, she's been clearing up. Former Galway footballer, I think.
So Leah Lyons just getting some treatment, bit of cramp I think setting in there. Chance now for Noel Stable to push this up the line, and with just over 5 minutes remaining, establish good field position for Ireland. Not quite to the 22, about 5 metres outside, but a platform nonetheless for Ireland to push on for the winning score here. Apologies, I hadn't realised that the match clock was being stopped, so there won't be injury time. There is just 5 minutes of play remaining now. I'm very slow to take the positions in this lineup, but successfully done. And Maz Riley been found by Leah Lyons. Kira Griffin now, crowd finding their voice.
Offside.
That did look like offside, but they haven't been picked up on it. Ireland, Maz Riley this time just outside the English 22. Stapleton just pulls that one back for Naupu. Alison Miller, Facebook 2, dragged down just inside the 22. Mary Healy, Stapleton, rear lines. Good recycling by Ireland here, good continuity. Griffin, Mairead Coyne now, looking to make the bust. Again, Sabin pulls that one back to Naupu. Fowley now. Ireland back and forth across the pitch, but no significant ground being made, has to be said. Paul of his back, a nice little show and go. Healy now, Maz Riley. No ground there. Stapleton chips for the corner. That's a super ball. And England under serious pressure at the back now. Just a couple of metres from their own try line, but they have secured possession and will clear down the line.
Super kick by Nora Stapleton and great chase by Niamh Kavanagh. You know, Ireland were to-ing and fro-ing across the pitch, probably 5 metres back from where the original line out started, so they weren't going anywhere. It was good defence by England, but great vision by Nora to see that space in behind, but it was only worth its kick by Kavanagh's chase.
Yeah, she's elected to kick fairly infrequently, but when she has done so, Nora Stapleton's positional kicking has been very good.
Again, England are now under pressure to win their line out and exit out of this 22.
So just over 2.5 minutes to go. Well, less than 2.5 minutes to go. Oh, that's giving us crooked in.
You could see the intent there from England though on the ground to make sure that Ireland didn't get any steam up on their maul. think Tom Tierney are very happy with the new caps again today. You know, Nicole Fowley hasn't looked out of place. Leah Lyons, Chloe Pierce coming on and really putting their hand up.
We certainly will. There's been hugely encouraging signs in this. And for a long period, Ireland were clearly the better team, I would suggest. It's a matter of whether they can actually bring it home over the and sneak the win in the last minute or two here. That's a great burst off the base there from Sarah Hunter. The pressure from Paula Fitzpatrick again behind the gain line. But England just winding down the clock now. Ireland need to make something happen out of one of these tackles. Trying to hold that one up, but to no effect. McLean has a good clearing kick. Murray Coyne is there though. Solid defence again. Kay Wilson has been solid any time Murray Coyne has tried to run those back. That's penalty against Danielle Waterman. I think she called a ruck and Waterman continued to try and play it on the ground.
Yeah, I think it's important for the English girls to listen to referee. She is talking to them. There's great hunger for them at the breakdown. It's just making sure they stay on their feet and do it legally.
So again, Ireland's last chance. It's now or never.
Prior to that, it was another great position for Murray Coyne for that kick from Katie McLean. You know, she's reading the game quite well at fullback.
So this will be the last play. Ireland need to score here if they're going to win this first of the November.
Six-man line-out. It looks like they're going to go to Maz Riley at two.
Indeed, it is Maz Riley at two. England get the counter drive on, though. Oh. See, Hayes getting done to that one off the ball, but the referee didn't notice. Leah Lyons now takes it on. It's going to be a dramatic win if it is to be a win now. Mary Healy again. Stapleton. But there are no holes there.
No, you have to give it to England's defence. You know, Ireland has thrown a lot at them and it's held firm through most of the game. Isolated.
Yeah, and that's snaffled on the deck by England. Turnover ball, and that, I would suggest, is going to be that.
Yeah, it was good carry from Katie Norris, but she was isolated.
Yes, and that's it. Ball off the pitch. Amy Pair blows the final whistle, and England have hung on for a narrow 12-10 win. Come from behind win, a match that Ireland played very well in for very long periods, but just in the final quarter, it got away from them.
Yeah, look, I think a disappointing result from Ireland, particularly in the manner in which they played and what they were trying to achieve. But they'll take a lot from this game. New caps, they'll learn a lot. They'll learn about game management, and it's good time of the year for these type of things to be happening. They'll look forward to Canada now in a week's time and next Saturday here, and they'll look to make some of those wrongs right. Likewise, England will look at their attack a little bit and look to improve on that. I thought their defence at times was very resolute and bounced back time and time again from a good Irish attack.
Yes, so we'll bid you adieu. Hopefully you can tune in again next week as Ireland take on Canada. There are still tickets available for that, which we got from Ticketmaster. And if it's as good again, it'll be a good game of rugby.
Yeah, definitely. And I think it's brilliant that the crowd are here today. And if we get more out supporting the girls, and I'm sure they'll put on a show next Saturday.
So thanks again for joining us. It's goodbye from me, Adrian O'Farrell, and from Fiona Cochran.
Bring memories of past glories. It'll bring new heights of belief and ambition. It'll bring the boldest hopes and the bravest dreams. It'll bring everyone to their feet. It'll bring a roar into every voice.
It'll bring this great game into a nation's heart. It'll bring the world to us and us to the world. Women's Rugby World Cup, Ireland, August 2017. Bring it.
Lifestyle. Heidi and Audina, eat your heart.